we're going to delve into some habitat science. There's been a long-standing question in fisheries management on what's the difference between just putting out a couple pieces of structure to attract fish versus actually improving total habitat for a lake. And we got some answers for you. We actually did a lot of that work on this property starting about 10 years ago. And we came up with, you know, the idea is if I put a piece of structure in the middle of the lake, there'll be fish on this probably within hours of you putting it out. They're just attracted to it if there's not a lot of it out there. The question was, how much of that do you need to put out there to actually improve the population? That's what we were going for. So the science aspect, we wanted to ask the question, how much habitat do we put into a lake to actually improve the infrastructure, make that lake, make all the habitat work for that fishery? Basically get it to the point where you don't have to worry about habitat anymore. You can go work on food or stocking or something else, but the habitat baseline is covered. So we went to the literature, we did some our own study, we did our own kind of questions on this, and the best number we came up with is somewhere around, you want to affect about 20% of a lake. And when I say of the lake, I don't mean the whole lake. 20% of the lake that's kind of shallower water. It depends on the lake. It's kind of a softer target, but I think of 8 to 10 to 12 foot of water and shallower in a lake, you want to take all that zone of a lake and affect 20% of it. You know, if you got a big, deep lake, you might have some offshore habitat in deeper water. You're not really worried about that. You're worried about that more productive zone in a smaller lake. Now, this lake is a brand new lake we're building. We're way offshore, and we've actually created humps. We've created our own shallow water offshore structure, so we're actually going to take this part into account and anything that's going to be in that more productive band of water. So 20%. You look at your lake, you figure out that band. It's usually just around the edge of the shoreline, 8 to 10 to 12 feet deep, and you go around that lake and you just trace how much shoreline that is, and you start to think about all that band of water and how much habitat I need to put in there to bring it up to affect 20% of it. So this is still a very active area of research in fisheries. Questions come in if you have aquatic vegetation, which I love aquatic vegetation. How much of that do you need, and how much of that can substitute for structure? I think the two types of habitat are very complementary. Aquatic vegetation, I always think of that as my underwater forest for a fish that's growing bugs, that's providing a lot of structure and cover. But this time of year, this is January, most of the vegetation's died off, so the value of that habitat's decreased, whereas the stuff we built is still sticking around. So there's benefits to both. But in a good, healthy lake, I try to have landowners and the lakes we manage, we try to maintain at least 20% aquatic vegetation in the spring, summer, and fall for all those positive benefits, as well as 20% of more complex structure with trees and rocks and brush piles, lay down logs, and artificial habitat. And I think the two work very well together.